1994 पासून 2007 पर्यंत 14 वर्षे विचारवेध संमेलने आयोजित होत असत. सातारा येथील आंबेडकर अकॅडमीतर्फे किशोर बेडकिहाळ आणि त्यांचे सहकारी निरनिराळ्या गावात तेथील कार्यकर्त्यांच्या सहयोगाने हे संमेलन आयोजित करीत. समाजाच्या प्रगतीसाठी निर्भीड आणि सखोल विचारमंथन करण्याचा विचारवेध संमेलनांचा ऐतिहासिक वारसा आहे. हा वारसा पुढे चालू ठेवण्यासाठी विचारवेध संमेलने पुन्हा सुरू होत आहेत. भारताच्या राज्यघटनेतील मार्गदर्शक तत्वे व मूलभूत अधिकार आणि सहिष्णुता, वैज्ञानिक दृष्टिकोन, सर्वसमावेशक विकास, समता, मैत्रीभाव यांच्याशी वैचारिक आणि भावनिक निष्ठा असणाऱ्या सर्वांना विचारवेध मंच हक्काने उपलब्ध आहे. वार्षिक संमेलनांच्या बरोबरच विचारवेध ही विविध माध्यमांतून लोकांपर्यंत पोहोचणारी सातत्याची चळवळ आहे. लोकांच्या विचारांना अभिव्यक्ती देणारे माध्यम आहे. विचारवेचे ही छोटी भाषणे सर्वांना सहज उपलब्ध आहेत.
I am Douglas Allen, and my topic is Hindutva, Hinduism versus Gandhi's Dharma, Hinduism. What we have here are two radically different, opposed views of Hinduism. Hindutva is an ideology. And the term was coined by Salvakar in 1923. And the term is meant to focus on Hindu-ness, and that in some essential way, Bharat or India has a Hindu essence. This is a Hindu nation. Gandhi was very familiar with this. He met Salvakar first in 1909 in London, just after one of Salvakar's disciples, a young student, had assassinated a British official. Gandhi debated Savarkar, and then on his return from London to Durban, South Africa, he wrote his famous work, Hind Swaraj, in which he attempts to refute the view of Savarkar that then developed into the ideology of Hindutva. Hindutva, of course, is the official ideology of the BJP, and it's also the ideology of the RSS, the Hindu Mahasabha, Shiv Sena, and many other groups, conservative, militant Hindu groups. Gandhi rejects that view of Hinduism. Now, what I find is that many of the Hindutva groups, including the ruling party today, attempts to appropriate Gandhi as a great Hindu, right? A national treasure, someone we should honor as part of this Hindutva ideology. Gandhi actually gives some fuel to this, because when you read Gandhi, there are isolated passages in which he uses very strong Hindu religious language. He often engages in specific Hindu rituals, Hindu prayers to Rama and other deities. He writes about cows, about Brahmacharya, about Ram Raja, uses very Hindu traditional language. And some of the rigid conservative Gandhians, they also view Gandhi in this very narrow, anti-Western Hindu way. But this is a misuse of Gandhi. Most of these passages are taken out of context, and when you look at the spirit, the approach that Gandhi has towards Hinduism, it radically rejects that Hindutva view of Hinduism. Now, in Hindutva Hinduism, there is a primary focus on ancient India, Vedic culture. This is the foundation of the true India. And it's a Hindu foundation in their view. Okay? And in fact, it's the view that ancient Indian culture provides us with all the values, all the solutions that we need to deal with the world in which we're living today. This is the true Hinduism. In the Hindutva view, Hinduism is engaged in a war, a militant war against all of these anti-Hindu forces, Muslim, Christian, Dalit, British, modern Western, and we have to defend the true Hindu faith. This is not Gandhi. Gandhi also, especially in Hind Swaraj, presents a very idealized view of ancient Indian civilization. He never calls it only Hindu, but he contrasts this with modern Western civilization, right? And he talks about ancient Indian civilization as the kingdom of God, the kingdom of good, and that it was always nonviolent, very idealized view. However, when Gandhi actually analyzes ancient Indian, Vedic, and other civilization, and several thousand years of what we call Hinduism, he's very critical. He says that this view of Hinduism has to be contextualized from the time. It's very incomplete. It was very hierarchical. It was oppressive and violent towards women, towards nature, towards others, and it needs to be purified. So, we have two different views of Hinduism. In the Hindutva view, from the Gandhian perspective, Hindutva Hinduism is very rigid. Gandhi's Hinduism is very flexible, very open-ended. Hindutva Hinduism is very aggressive. Very aggressive. Gandhi's Hinduism, Gandhi is a karma yogin. In his Hinduism, Hindus should be proactive, right? But they should not be aggressive and should not be violent. In Gandhi's view, Hindutva, and especially today, it's extremely chauvinistic. It thinks it has the truth, and not only does it have the truth, but it is superior. The other views are false. We have the true culture, the true religion, the true civilization. Gandhi is always against religious chauvinism, national chauvinism, in which you think you're superior and that you have the truth. From Gandhi's point of view, and you see this all over India today, Hindutva Hinduism is extremely intolerant. Intolerant. It's intolerant of others who do not agree with its view of Hinduism. Gandhi's Hinduism is extremely tolerant. It's tolerant of all kinds of other points of view. From Gandhi's point of view, Hindutva Hinduism today is very violent, physically violent. It uses violent language. It's economically, culturally, religiously very violent. Gandhi's Hinduism embraces ahimsa. This is the Hinduism he wants to develop, that's based on loving kindness, compassion, caring for the needs of others, for all suffering beings. In Gandhi's view, Hindutva Hinduism is extremely hierarchical. It has hierarchy of caste. It is very Brahmin-centric. When you look underneath the rhetoric, it actually upholds caste privilege, traditional caste privilege within Hinduism. It's very hierarchical in terms of gender oppression. It's a male privileged Hinduism, and it's very hierarchical in its attitude towards others who do not, Adivasis, Dalits, people who are not Hindus, or people who are Hindus and don't accept its rigid view of Hinduism. Gandhi is the exact opposite. Gandhi's Hinduism is egalitarian. Egalitarian. It's anti-caste in his own life, his own commitments, and if you look closely, his own view of Hinduism, it is very anti-caste. It endorses gender equality. Gandhi knows that traditional Hinduism is patriarchal, but the Hinduism he believes in, which is constantly growing, developing, must embrace gender equality. So in Gandhi's view of Hinduism, Hinduism is open, it's tolerant, it respects others. Gandhi says in his Hinduism, we can learn from other points of view. That's why Gandhi says in different passages, I am a Christian, I am a Buddhist, I am a Jain, I am a Muslim, I am a Jew. He says, I am a woman. He says, oh, and each of these things he says is very deep in meaning. And Gandhi says, when I am open and learn from others, including the West, he learned a lot from the West, I become a better Hindu. That's how I become a better Hindu, right? So I would say finally, as opposed to Hindutva Hinduism, Gandhi's Hinduism is inclusivistic, not exclusivistic. It is pluralistic, right? Pluralistic, and it is democratic in the sense of being egalitarian. Hinduism should promote nonviolence, egalitarian, non-hierarchical, true democratic values. And for Gandhi, Hinduism is not something closed, absolute set. In other words, we are constantly defining and redefining what is Hinduism by how we live our lives. So I think we have a contrast, two views of Hinduism, and I think in terms of the future of India and the world, the Gandhian view is the one that speaks to our human condition and the crises we are facing today.